τους φυλαχθήν ημάς.
Ευλογητός Κύριε, ο Θεός των Πατέρων ημών, και ενετών και δεδοξασμένων, το όνομά Σου εις τους αιώνας. Αμήν.
Γέννητο Κύριε, το ελαιός Σου έφημα, καθά περιουπίσαμεν επί Σε.
Ευλογητός Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα Σου.
Ευλογητός Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα Σου.
Ευλογητός Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα Σου.
Κύριε, καταφυγήν εγεννήθης ημίν, εν γενναίο και γενναία, εγώ είπα Κύριε, ελέησόν με, ίασε την ψυχήν μου, ότι μαρτώνσι.
Κύριε, προσέ κατεφυγόν, διδαξόν με, του ποιήν το θέλημά Σου, ότι Συ ο Θεός μου.
Ότι παρασύ πηγή ζωής εν το φωτί Σου, ο ψώμεθα φως.
Παράτινον το ελαιός Σου, της γίνος κουσίσε. Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι.
Και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δε faithful men. For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ της ειρηνίας του σύμπαντος κόσμου, ευσταθείας των Αγίων του Θεού Εκκλησίων και της των πάντων ενώσεως του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν. For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτερίου της εν Χριστώ Διακονίας, πάντως του κλήρου και του λαού του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν. For the President of the United States, for those in civil authority, for the armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ της πόλεως ταύτης, πόσης πόλεως χώρας και των πιστικών των εναυτές του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν. For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. Ipe pleondon adi porundon, aeroporundon, osundon gamnon, ekmaloton, ke disoterias afton, tu Kyriou deithomen. For deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Αντιλαβούς ως τον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχωρητή. Της Παναγίας ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και Άη Παρθένου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντε σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών, Χριστού του Θεού παραθούμεθα. Ότι πρέπει εσύ πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκύνηση στο Πατρί και του Υιό και του Αγίου Πνεύματι νυν και Άγιοι, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Ευλόγη ψυχή μου τον Κύριον και πάντα τα εντός μου το όνομα του Άγιον αυτού.
Lord our God, whose dominion is inconceivable, whose glory is incomprehensible, whose mercy is infinite, whose love doth draw near toward mankind is inevitable to thyself, O Master, in thy tender compassion look down upon us and upon this holy temple, and grant us and those who pray with us thine abundant mercies and compassions.
Κύριος εν το ουρανό, ετοίμασε τον θρόνον αυτού, και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorated, O most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. For thine is the dominion, thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Εν η ψυχή μου των Κυρίων, εν εσώ Κύριον εν τη ζωή μου. ψαλώ το Θεό μου έως υπάρχος.
Master, Lord our God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Protect the whole body of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy temple. Do thou endow them with the divine power and forsake not us who set our hope in thee.
Βοηθός αυτού, η ελπής αυτού, επί Κυρίων των Θεών αυτού.
Thou hast given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and did promise that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will grant their petitions fulfilled. Now, Lord, the petitions of your servants as may be the most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth and of the world to come life everlasting. Και την ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν. Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχαρητή. Της Παναγίας Ακράντο υπερευλογημένης εν δόξα δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αη Πάρθενο Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθώ. Ότι αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωμεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας, τον αιώνων.
Αμήν. Αυτή η μέρα Κυρίου αγαλιασόμεθα και φρανθούμεν εν αυτή. Έφρενε στο τα ουρανία, αγαλία στο τα επίγεια. Ότι επίησε κράτος εν βραχίον η αυτού ο Κύριος, επάτησε το θάνατο τον θάνατο.
Σοφία ορθή, δεύτε προς προσκυνήσομεν και προσπέσομεν Χριστό. Σώσον ημάς, Υιέ Θεού, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρό.
Στο τα ουράνια, γαλλία, στο τα επίγεια, ότι επίησε κράτος εμβραχίων η αυτού, ο Κύριος επάτησε το θάνατο των θανάτων. Πρωτότοκος των νεκρών εγένετο, εκκυλίας άδου ερίσατο ημάς και παρέσχε το κόσμο το μέγα έλεος.
Τας του πλάνου παγίδας εκφυγών ιερότατε, απλανώσε πορεύθης διαβίου πατήρι μου, Νικόλαε αείδη με πλάνα, ουράνια χαρίσματα
λαβών,
αγρυπνίες και νηστείες ιερουργών οσίας το Κύριο σου.
Ον περκαθηκετεύων εκτενός, να αξιών ιερατεύμα πρεσβεύε δωρηθήνε και ημίν το Θείον έλεος.
Την πανεπιμονή φι Χριστού υμνήσομεν, εκατέριναν την Θείαν και πολιούχον σύνα, την βοήθειαν ημών και αντίληψη, ότι εφήμως ελαμπρός τους κόψους των ασεβών του πνεύματος τη δύναμη, και νύνος μάρτης τεθήσα ετήτε πάση το μεγά έλεος.
Μνήστη την Κύριε ως αγαθός του δούλος, και όσα εν βίω ημαρτών συγχωρήσω εις γαρράν αμαρτητός, ημισιοδυναμένος, και της μεταστάση δούνε την αναπάση.
Εν τη γεννήσει,
τη σοφία οδηγέ, φρονήσεως χωρίγε, των αφρόνων παιδευτά και πτωχών υπεράσπιστα, στήριξον συνέτησον την καρδίαν μου,
δέσποτας η δίδουμη λόγων.
Ον του Πατρός λόγος η δούγαρ τα χείλη μου, ου μη κολλήσω εν το κράζηση. Ελεήμον ελεήσον με τον παραπέσοντα.
Let us pray to the Lord. For thy God art holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. O holy God, who rest among thy saints, who art glorified by the cherubim and praised by the seraphim with the thrice holy voice, worship by all the hosts of heaven, thou who hast brought all things out of nothingness into being, thou hast created man in thine own image and likeness, and hast adorned him with all thy favors, thou who givest to the supplicant wisdom and prudence, and did not neglect the sinner, but hast set forth a way of repentance unto salvation. Thou hast accounted us thy humble and unworthy servants, worthy to stand at this time before the glory of thy holy altar, and to bring to thee adoration and praise. Do thou, Master, accept me from the mouth of us sinners, the thrice holy visit in him, and visit us with the righteousness, visit and forgive us of all our transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship thee in holiness all the days of our life. Through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints, who from the beginning of time have pleased thee, for thou art God and holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Καθέδραν.
Ψάλατε το Θεό ημών, ψάλατε πάντα τα έθνη κροτήσατε χείρας.
Σοφία.
Προς Ρωμαίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Προσκομέν.
Αδελφοί, νυν εγκύτερον ημών η σωτηρία, Ιώστε επιστεύσαμεν, η νύξ προέκυψεν, η δε ημέρα ήγηκεν. Αποθώμεθα ου τα έργα του σκότους και ενδυσσόμεθα τα όπλα του φωτός. Ον εν ημέρα εσύ μόνος περιπατήσομεν, μην κόμεις και μέθες, μη κοίτες και ασελγίες, μη έριδι και ζήλο, αλ ενδύσατε τον Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν. Και τη σαρκός πρόνοιας μη ποιείστε εις επιθυμίαν, το δε ασθενούντα την πίστην προσλαμβάνεστε, μη εις διάκρισιν διαλογισμών, ως μεν πιστεύει φαγήν πάντα, ο δε ασθενών λάχανα εστί, ο εστίον το μη εστίοντα μη εξουθήνετο και η μη εστίον. Τον εστίοντα μη κρινέτο, ο Θεός γάρ αυτό προσελάβετο, σύ της εις κρίνων αλότριον ηκέτην. Το ίδιον Κύριο στήκη πίπτη σταθήσετε δε δυνατός γαρέστην ο Θεός στήσε αυτόν.
Let us attend.
Sing praises to our God, sing praises. Clap your hands, all you nations.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Romans.
Let us attend.
Brethren, salvation is nearer to us now than when we first believed. The night is far gone, the day is at hand. Let us then cast off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves becomingly as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. As for the man who is weak in faith, welcome him, but not for disputes over opinions. One believes he may eat anything, while the weak man eats only vegetables. Let not him who eats despise him who abstains, and let not him who abstains pass judgment on him who eats, for God has welcomed him. Who are you to pass judgment on the servant of another? It is before this his own master that he stands or falls, and he will be upheld. For God is able to make him stand.
Peace be with you, the reader. Σοφία ορθή, ακούσουμε το Άγιο Ευαγγελίο, ειρήνη πάση. Εκ του κατά Ματθαίον Άγιο Ευαγγελίο το ανάγνωσμα, προσκομεν. Είπεν ο Κύριος, εάν αφείτε της ανθρώπης τα παροπτώματα αυτών, αφήσει και ημίν ο πατήρ μον ουράνιος. Εάν δε μη αφείτε της ανθρώπης τα παροπτώματα αυτών, ουδέ ο πατήρ ημών αφήσει τα προπτωματά ημών. Όταν δεν νηστεύετε, μη γίνεστε ως περ οι υποκριτές κρυπτοποί, αφανίζωσι γάρ τα πρόσωπα αυτών, όπως φανώσει τις ανθρώπις νηστεύοντες. Αμήν αμήν λέγω ημίν ότι απέχωσι των μισθών αυτών. Σι δεν νηστεύουν, αλυψέ σου την κεφαλήν και το πρόσωπον σου νύψε, όπως μη φανείς της ανθρώπης νηστεύων, αλλά το πατρί σου το εν το κρυπτό και ο πατήρ σου ο βλέπον εν το κρυπτό, αποδώσου σι εν το φανερό. Μη θησαυρίζεται ημίν θησαυρούς, επί της γης όπου σεις και βρώσεις αφανίζει και όπου κλέπτε διορίσωση και κλέπτουση. Θησαυρίζεται δε ημίν θησαυρούς εν ουρανό, όπου ούτε σεις ούτε βρώσεις αφανίζει και όπου κλέπτε ου διορίσουσιν ουδε κλέπτουσιν. Όπου γάρεστην ο θησαυρός ημών, εκεί εστέ και η καρδία ημών. The reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Let us attend. The Lord said, if you forgive men of their trespasses, your heavenly Father also will forgive you. But if you do not forgive men of their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive you of your trespasses. So when you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces that their fasting may be seen by all men. Truly, truly, I say to you, you have received, and they have received their reward. But I tell you, when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may not be seen by men, but by your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you justly. Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume and where the thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Grant that being ever protected by thy power, to thee we may ascribe glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. No one who is bound with the desires and pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach or draw near, or to serve thee as O King of glory.
For to serve thee is great and awesome, even to the heavenly powers, yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind. Thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and served as our high priest, and as Lord of all is committed to us the celebration of the liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. For thou, our Lord, our God, rulest over all things in heaven and earth, who art born under the throne of the cherubim, and our Lord of the seraphim, the King of Israel, who alone art holy, rests among thy saints. Wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant. Look down upon me, and cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience, and enable me by the whole power of the Holy Spirit, vested with the grace of the priesthood, to stand before this thy holy altar, and consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood. For to thee I come, having bowed my head and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither reject me from among thy children, but make me worthy thy sinful and worthy servant to offer these gifts unto thee. For thou art the offered, the accepted, the distributed of Christ our God. And to thee we ascribe glory, together with thine eternal Father and thy holy, good, life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Τα χειροβιμή σε κοσκονίζουν έως πάσα προσωπικά ως τον βασιλεύνο της ειδικές. Δια φρουτάξ, αλληλούια, αλληλούια, αλληλούια. Προϋψή με τον Κύριον και εγκαλία σου το Πνεύμα μου πως είναι.
Pandon imon. Και πάντων των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών. Μνηστή Κύριος ο Θεός, εν τη βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νυν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord. Ondilavus oson eleison ge diaphylaxon imas o Theos tis ichariti. Imeron pasan telian agian irinikin ke da martiton, ore tu kiriu eti sumetho. For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. For the forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. Καλά και συμφέροντα τες ψυχές ημών, κυρίνει το κόσμο παρά του Κυρίου ετισόμεθο. Αλλά σου, Κύριε. Λοιπόν, χρόνων της ζωής ημών, εν ειρήνη και μετανοία εκτελέσε, παρά του Κυρίου ετισόμεθο. Of our lives may be Christian without pain, blameless and peaceful, and for good account at the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Σπουναγία σακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσπίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένο Μαρίας, μετά πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσεντε σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών. Στον το Θεό παραθούμεθο. Δια των νυκτυρμών και μονιανού σου Υιού μεθού ευλογητός εις συν το Παναγίου και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Confess. Ate, 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 Ate,
dosa mesu imoni in kesti kesti.
Θαστήρας εν σοφία προσκομέν.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεόν, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης, ορατών δε πάντων και αοράτων, και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησού Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός γεννηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων. Φως εκ φωτός, Θεόν αληθινών εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννηθέντα, ουποιηθέντα, ομοούσιον του Πατρίδιου τα πάντα ηγένετο. Τον
δήμας
τους ανθρώπους και δια την μετέραν σωτηρίαν, κατελθόντα εκ των ουρανών και σαρκωθέντα εκ θέματος Αγίου και Μαρίας Παρθένου και ανθρωπίσαντα, σταυρωθέντα τα υπερημών, επί Ποντίου Πιλάτου και παθόντα και τα πέντα και αναστάντα τη τρίτη ημέρα κατά τας γραφάς. Και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς και κατεζόμενον εκ δεξιών του Πατρός και πάλι ερχόμενον με τα δόξης κρίνε ζώντας και νεκρούς ούτης βασιλείας ούτ και στε τέλος
και εις το πνεύμα το Άγιον τον Κύριον των ζωπιών
το εκ του Πατρός εκπορευόμενο το συμπατρί και Υιός προσκυνούμενο και συνδοξαζόμενο το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών εις μίαν Αγίαν,
Καθολική
και Αποστολική Εκκλησία,
ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών,
προσδοκώ Ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Στομεν καλός, στομεν με το φόβο, προσκομεν την Αγίαν εν αφοράν εν ειρήνη προσφέρειν. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Let us lift up our hearts. Give thanks to the Lord. Τον επινίκιον ύμνον άδοντα, βούντα,
ke kragwa da ke legunda.
With these blessed powers, O Master, who loves mankind, we also cry and say out, Holy, that only begotten Son of the Holy Spirit, holy art thou in all holy, magnificent is thy glory. Who didst so love the world as to give thine only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Who having come and having fulfilled all the dispensation for us in the night, betrayed or rather surrendered himself for life in the world, having taken bread in his holy and immaculate and blameless hands, and thanked and blessed and sanctified and broken, and gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, το σώμα του επέριμον γλωμένον εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Take ye, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins. Likewise the cup after the supper, saying, Ιδ εξ αυτού πάντες, τούτο εστί το αίμα μου τη δυσχενής διαθήκης, το επέριμον και πελών ευκοινόμενον εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον, drink from it ye all. This is my blood of the New Testament, which for many and you is shed, unto remission of sin. Therefore, remembering this command of our Savior and all that he endured for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sitting at the right hand, the second and glorious coming again. Προσφέρομεν κατά πάντα και δια πάντα. To thee this rational and bloodless worship. And we beseech thee and pray and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. May be to those who receive them for the purification of the soul, for the remission of sins, for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, for the boldness to approach thee neither unto judgment nor unto condemnation. Again we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, the forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every spirit made perfect in faith. Υπότιτλοι AUTHORWAVE.
αιρέτος της Παναγίας Σακράντου, υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσμής ημών Θεοτόκου, και αϊπαρθένου Μαρίας.
Αξιών εστίος αλήθος, μακαρίς είσαι την
Μίσθητη Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, ον χάρισε της Αγίας ο Κλησιρήνη, σον εν ημών Ιαμακρυμερεύοντα και έρθω του μούντα των λόγων της εις αληθείας, και ον έκαστος κατ' οδιάνιαν έχει και πάντων και πασών. Grant us that with one mouth and one heart we may glorify and praise that all-honorable name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. In the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with you all. Having commemorated all the saints, again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For these precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. Merciful God, who hath received them on his holy and celestial and invisible altar unto a scent of spiritual fragrance, may send down upon us divine grace, the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Ενότητα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος ετισάμενοι αυτούς και αλλήλους, και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθόν. Και καταξίωσον ημάς Δέσποτε με την παρησία σα κατακρίτως τόλμαν επικαλείστε σε τον επράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγει Πάτρι μόν που εν της ουρανής αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης. Τον άρτον ημών των υπιουσιών, δώσει μην σήμερον, και άφεση μην τα φιλήματα ημών. Ως και εμείς αφήμεν σε φιλέτης ημών, και εμείς εν έγκριση μας πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσε εμάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
with you. Let us bow our heads unto the Lord. Through the grace and mercy and love for mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Μιλήσετε και διεμερίζετε ο μνός του Θεού, μιλιζόμενος, ο μη διρούμενος, ο πάντοτε στιόμενος και μηδέπεθο ο μνός του Θεού, ο Θεός ζεάζουν. Πλήρωμα ποτηρίου πίστεως πνεύματος Αγίου. Ευλογημένη ζέση του Αγίου του Κύριε πάντοτε νικία, η Κέσος ελούνας των αιωνίων, ζέσης πίστης πλήρης. The Son of the living God, who has come into the world to save sinners, of whom we are the first. Also, we believe that this is thy sacred body and this is thy precious blood. Therefore, we pray to thee, have mercy on us and pardon our transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, both known and unknown, and make us worthy to partake of thy mysteries, unto the remission of sins and unto life eternal. Amen. Behold, we approach for Holy Communion, Creator, burners, and us to partake. For thou art fire which burns the unworthy, wherefore do thou cleanse us from every stain. Receive us today, O Son of God, as partake of thy mystical feast, when us to the doing of his glory. Του δείπνωσε το μυστικό σημείο του Θεού Κοινούνου παράλαβε. Ο μηγάτης εκ Χριστού των μυστήριων υπόν, ο φίλοι μας οδώσε κάθε περίοδας. Αλλός ο ληστής ομολογός ημείς του μου Κύριε. Μεταδίδωτε με Τιμωθέο τον αξίο ιερομονάχο των τίμων και πράγιων, σώμα εις άφησε μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Έτι μεταδίδωτε με Τιμωθέο τον αξίο ιερομονάχο των τίμων και πράγιων, αίμα εις άφησε μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Στο όνομα του Πατρός. Αμήν και του Υιού. Αμήν και του Αγίου Πνεύματος. Αμήν, τούτο υψηλέω μου πριν μου καθαρί.
Με το φόβο Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσέρθετε. Constantinos. His commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Georgia is commune for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Georgia is commune for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Vani duri to theo. Stina is avis matrion kezrin elion amin. Servant of God, for the remission of her sins or life everlasting. Servant of God, Constantinos is commune for the remission of his sins or for life everlasting. Servant of God, Nicholas is commune for the remission of his sins or for life everlasting. Servant of God, for the remission of her sins or for life everlasting. Servant of God, life everlasting. The Lavani Dulia to Theo. Maria is Absamartion, Kezuin, Union Amin. The servant of God. Generation of her sins. And for life everlasting. Servant of God. Lucas is commune for the mission of his sins and for life everlasting. Σώσον ο Θεός των λαών σου και ευλογήσον την κληρονομία σου. Πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly life, giving in awesome mysteries of Christ, worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having asked the Lord that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Ο Αγίος μας ημών και εσύ την δόξαν να πέμπωμεν, το Πατρίν και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματιν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Εν ειρήνη προέρθομεν του Κυρίου δαϊθόμεν. Ο ευλογώντες ευλογούνται σε Κύριε και αγιάζουν τις επιπιθώτας όσων ο λαόν σου και ευλογήσουν την κληρονομία σου. Το πλήρωμα της Εκκλησίας σου φύλαξον, αγίασον τους καπώνες του πρεπέγεν του οίκου σου. Συ αυτούς αντιδόξασον, τη θεϊκή σου δυνάμη και μη εγκατελείπης μας σου ελπίσον σε πισέ. Ειρήνη του κόσμου σου δώρησε, της Εκκλησίας σου τη ιερεύση της άρχουσον ημών το στρατό και παιδί το λαό σου. Ότι πάσα δώσεις αγαθή και πάντρο μετέλεον, άνωθεν εστι κατεβαίνουν εξού του Πατρός των φώτων. Και εσύ την δόξαν και ευχαριστίαν και προσκύνησαν να πέμπομεν τον Πατρί και τον Υιό και τον Αγίο Πνεύμα την ίν και άει και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
O Christ our God, who art thyself fulfilled with the law of the prophets, who has fulfilled all this petition, of the Father, fill our hearts with joy and gladness, always now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαίωματά σου τον Αγίον ο χορός ευρεπιήν τη ζωή και θύραν παραδείσου ευρωκαγώ την οδόν δια της μετανοίας το πολλολός προβατών εγώ ημί ανακαλέσε με σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαίωματά σου ανάπασον ο Θεός τους δούλους σου και κατάταξον αυτούς εν παραδείσο όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δίκαιοι εκλάψουν συνοσφαστήρες τους και κοιμημένους δούλους σου ανάπασον παρορών αυτών πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the tri-brilliance of the Godhead singleness, let us praise reverently chanting, Holy are you, the beginningless Father, co-beginningless Son, and Holy Spirit, shine upon us who in faith worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν χαίρεσαι μνήν Θεός αρχιτεκούσα εις πάντων σωτηρίαν διγένος των ανθρώπων εύρωτον την σωτηρίαν δια σου εύρημεν παράδεισον Θεοτό και αγνή ευλογημένη.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο
Θεός. Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, 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 glory to you, O God.
Oh, με το πνευμά των δικαίων τα τελειωμένοντας ψυχάς των δούλων σου σώταρν απαύσον φιλά των αυτάσι στην μακαρίεν ζωή την παρασύ φιλάνθρωπε.
Κατά παυσήν σου Κύριε όπου πάντες οι Άγιοι σου αναπαύονται ανάπαυσον Κύριε. Και τα ψυχάς των δούλων σου, ότι μόνος υπάρχεις αθάνατο.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You are God who descended into Hades, and into the sufferings of all who were in prison. O Savior, also rest the souls of these your servants.
Και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Ημών η Άγνη και Αχράντος Παρθένος, η Θεόν Αφράστος Κύσσασα, πρέσβευε υπέρ του ελεηθήνε τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray to you, hear us and have mercy. Έτι διαμαθά υπέρ αναπαυσέως τας ψυχάς των και κειμένων δούλων του Θεού, Κωνσταντίνο Ελένης και Γεωργίας, και υπέρ συγχωρηθήν αυτής παμπλημέλη ακούσιον τε και ακούσιον. That the Lord God will place their souls where the righteous rest and will grant to them the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven and the forgiveness of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord. O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and crushed the power of the devil, granted life to your world, do yourself, O Lord, give rest to the souls of these your servants, Konstantinos, Eleni, and Yeoria, who have fallen asleep in a place of light, a place of green pasture, a place of repose, where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which they have committed in word or deed or thought, for you are a good God who loves mankind. For there is no one who lives and does not sin. Only you are without sin, and your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. To Kyrie eleithomen. Οδησίον ως τα ζήσει ζωή και μακαρίαν απαυσής των κεκειμένων δούλων του Θεού, Κωνσταντίνου Ελένης και Γεωρίας, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπωμεν. Σύ το ανάξω Πατρί και το Παναγίο και κατ' οξο ποιό σου πνεύμα τον Ινκιαή και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ευνία συμνήμη αξιωμακάριστη και εμνηστή αδελφοί ημών. Ευνία συμνήμη αξιωμακάριστη και εμνηστή αδελφοί ημών. Everlasting be your memory, who are worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Αιωνία ημνή, αιωνία ημνή, αιωνία αυτός ημνή.
Ευλογία Κύριου και Ελέος αυτού ευθυμαστή αυτού Θεία χάριτη και φιλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και άει και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Δόξα Σύ ο Θεός ελπίσιμον Κύριε δόξα Σύ.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι και νυν και άει και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν.
Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε, ευλόγησον.
Ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός, αληθινός ο Θεός ημών, της πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και παραμόμου Αγίας Αυτομητρός, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Εζωπιού Σταυρού, προστασίας του Τιμίου Ροπρανίων δυνάμενων σωμάτων, ηγεσίας του Τιμίου ενδόξου προφήτου, προδρόμου και βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και επαναφήμων Αποστόλων, των Αγίης Πατέρων ημών μεγάλων ηχών και δασκάλων, των Αγίης Πατρός ημών Ιωάννου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινούπολεως του Χρυσοστόμου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και Ελληνικών μαρτύρων, των Οσύγχων Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώρων Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, των Αγίων Θεοδότου Επισκόπου εν Κύπρου, ησυχίου και ευθαλίας των μαρτύρων και πάντων των Αγίων Ελίσσης και σώσε ημάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελεήμων Θεός. Διευχών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. Η Αγία Τριάστια φυλάξε πάντας ημάς.
Είμαστε πάνω από 50. Εσύ ακόμα έχεις καιρό. Αλλά κάτσε. Για να κάτσε.
Good morning. I hope that we all are aware that tomorrow we begin our great and holy Lent. And tomorrow is Kathara Deftera, Clean Monday. We begin our strict fast, and tomorrow is a totally strict fast day from oil, from meat, from dairy products, and the like. And in conjunction with the first day of Lent, we will begin our Lenten schedule. Stewards of the parish should have received. If not, you'll be getting it tomorrow or the next day. But most, I think, have received it, the schedule for the entire Lenten season. And tomorrow we begin with our great compline service, the service of forgiveness. And that is at 5:30 in the evening, followed by our traditional Lenten meal in Plato Hall. There's information in your bulletin about that. On Wednesday evening, we begin the first of our Wednesday pre-sanctified, our Proyasmenes, and the pre-sanctified liturgy will be at 6 o'clock on Wednesday evening. And to keep in mind that we alternate every Wednesday. The second week of Lent, it'll be in the morning, and then the third week, it'll be in the evenings, and so forth. And then on Friday, we begin the first of our Hieretes Mi services, the first salutation to the Theotokos. And on Saturday, we finish with our third and final Saturday of the Souls. So that is the first week of Lent, and in line with that, this evening begins our Sunday evening solemn Vesper services at the various parishes throughout the Chicago area. Tonight's service will take place at Holy Trinity, and I believe that service is at 7 o'clock this evening with the service of forgiveness tonight. So the service is at Hagia Triada, at Holy Trinity, beginning at 7 o'clock this evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. As we just mentioned, we now stand at the doorstep on this, the Sunday, Cheese Fair Sunday. We stand on the doorstep of Great Lent. And we know, of course, that tomorrow our Holy Orthodox Church enters into Kathara Deftera, Clean Monday, which, as I said, is a day of strict fasting and prayer. This day, Clean Monday, is an opportunity for each of us to turn our thoughts, as we have been nudged the last three or four Sundays with through the gospel lessons, to turn our thoughts, our souls, our actions, and our bodies to the great sacrifice of Jesus and what he did for us, that being the salvation of our souls. If we recap the themes from the prior four Sunday gospel readings, including today's, during this period of the Triodion, it dealt with many various virtues and models that we should work on to incorporate into our lives during this most holy season of preparation. If we recall three, four Sundays ago, first we were asked to be humble like the publican from the Gospel of the Publican and the Pharisee. Secondly, we were asked on the following Sunday to be forgiving and accepting like the waiting and patient father in the Gospel of the Prodigal Son. Thirdly, we were told last week about, which took on a more sombering and serious note, about the final judgment and how God would judge each of us by our relationships and how we should deal with our neighbors. And this morning, our gospel reading that we heard in our divine liturgy tells of Jesus' instructions to us on forgiveness, fasting, giving, and sharing, and not to be hypocrites and to show off. These last four Sundays, our Holy Orthodox Church uses the gospel message of Jesus as a form of instruction and catechism leading up to Great Lent. It is designed to prepare us, if we take seriously each and every one of those virtues, and to experience and properly prepare for the death and ultimate glorious resurrection of Jesus Christ. Our church this morning captures Jesus' words so beautifully in the Gospel of St. Matthew that we heard, and gives us these words of instruction on forgiveness and fasting. We heard these words. If you forgive others of the wrongs they have done to you, your Father in heaven will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, then your Father will not forgive the wrongs you have done. And then he goes on further to say about fasting. And when you fast, do not put on a sad face as the hypocrites do, for they neglect their appearance so that everyone will see that they are fasting. I assure you, they have already been paid in full. When you go without food, wash your face and comb your hair so that others cannot know that you are fasting. Only your Father who is unseen will know. And your Father who sees what you do in private will reward you. The first task of Great Lent, my dear friends, is that we need to deal with is repentance. We are invited to bring our sins and lay them before the feet of God. And what a gift that invitation is, because all of us carry so much guilt. And this guilt, no matter how irrational, can seem so real. Great Lent for the Orthodox Christian is a time of repentance. It's a time of catharsis, a time of cleansing. It is a time for confession of our sins and the beginning of a new life. Secondly, Great Lent offers us a time of absolution, because it does no good for us to confess our sins if we keep beating ourselves over it. If you sinned, you ask for repentance, and God forgives you. This may be the chief reason why so many people fail to truly repent and begin new lives, because they never experience the absolution or forgiving power of God, because they do not really believe down deep that God, or anyone else for that matter, can or will forgive them. A very astute clergyman once said that the devil has two lies he uses at two different stages. First, before we commit a sin, the devil tells us that one little sin doesn't matter because no one will know. The second lie is after we've sinned, when he tells us that we're doomed, and that it's hopeless, and we're condemned. But Great Lent is a time to change that and to right the wrongs of our life. It is a time of repentance and a time of absolution. And third, Great Lent is also a time of spiritual renewal. It is a time of turning our bodies over to Christ and allowing Him to carry them on our behalf. We think we're so great that we can carry the world on our shoulders. And then when we collapse, we ask why. Great Lent is a time to strengthen our relationship with our Lord God and to turn over our problems to Him. And this is accomplished through prayer and fasting and participation in our Lenten worship services. What would your answer be if someone was to ask you, how often do you sit and meditate by reading the Bible? Can you even find the Bible in your house? Great Lent is an excellent time to acquaint yourself with the Bible if you don't do so already. Great Lent is the right time to prepare yourself properly and more often to receive the body and blood of Christ. Great Lent is a perfect time to concentrate more intently on changing in a positive manner the direction of your mind and soul to a Christ-centered life. Great Lent for us is that special time to weed out and cancel unnecessary activities to find and create time for God and our soul. Time to stop and live. Time to accumulate all our thoughts and our purposes and direct them to God. Great Lent offers us that because it allows us to get to know Christ personally, and that is the greatest treasure there is. Remember, without faith, no man can be saved. Faith is so powerful, says the Lord, that it literally can move mountains. So we need to resist the temptation of some of our brothers and sisters who only fool themselves when they boastfully say, I can pray and worship God in my own way. And just because I'm not in church on Sunday does not mean that I am any less a Christian. Those people are misinformed. Some of our misguided souls believe that it is possible to do good works without having faith. But it isn't. Because being inside the church means to be a follower of Christ. And that means giving of our time and our talents and our treasure. For Jesus Christ Himself said, there is no salvation outside the church. My dear friends, for Great Lent to be meaningful to today's grown-ups and families, we have to put it in context of today's culture. At one time, there were no parties. There were no school dances. There weren't even baptisms permitted during Great Lent. Great Lent was meant to be a time of total concentration and preparation and cleansing of one's soul and body. But today, if we say to today's young people, no, you can't go to that party because it's Great Lent, we're apt to get a look that says, what's Lent got to do with it? So how do we turn around and celebrate Great Lent in a meaningful way in our lives and families? We can do so by heeding the words of this morning's gospel message. We need to not be hypocritical or show off that we are fasting. People that call themselves ultra-Orthodox go around looking like it's the last days on earth. Our gospel reading doesn't talk about that today. It says when you fast, you should smile. When you fast, no one should know it. But yet we have monastics in this world that think and teach the people wrongly. When you fast, you should be happy. Our gospel says that. We need to not be hypocritical or show off that we are fasting. We need to look forward to it by talking about the opportunity it gives us as a family to be together, to quiet our busy lives a little, and to initiate some ways to come closer together with one another and God, and to have fun while we are doing it. Contrary to what the monasteries tell you, God never told us that Great Lent should be grim and something to be dreaded. Didn't He say to us in today's gospel reading that when we fast, no one should even know it? That's how we will be rewarded, by not bragging. Jesus says that we should smile and we should even laugh when we fast and pray, because we know why we're fasting. We're fasting for the glorious resurrection, not for our death. Jesus says that we should smile. Jesus says that we should laugh. And we don't have to put on pious and painful looks on our faces, nor churchy voices when we talk about Jesus. Finally, Jesus this morning says that Great Lent, however, does require participation. It means involvement. It means commitment. So as we begin tomorrow, Clean Monday, the first day of our Great Lenten journey, our church asks us to reflect on the themes of the gospel readings of these past four Sundays: humility, repentance, judgment, and this morning's reading about fasting the right way and by doing good works for all people. Our church asks us to implement all of these directives which our Lord touched upon in His messages to us these past weeks. And He tells us first that we must make the effort to forgive our friends and enemies just as we want and expect God to forgive us of our sins. Secondly, that this year we need to make the extra effort to fast properly, both from food and in our actions, by watching what we say, what we hear, and what we think, which are just as important as what we abstain from. And third, as we heard in our gospel message this morning, it tells us, let us lay up our treasures in heaven, meaning let us do good works in God's name. Let us reserve time in each day to pray and read the Bible. And let us be more faithful to the extra Lenten worship services that are there, not for the priest's edification, but for yours, so that you may participate and prepare yourselves properly. For if all of us incorporate these things into our lives during this most holy season of Great Lent, I'm confident that this year we will truly experience a most meaningful and rewarding and spiritually fulfilling Pascha. Amen.